Here's my hand, and with it I give you all of my heart.
Come along now, not so shy. Give him your hand too, then you'll be properly betrothed, and then you'll be married.
Dear Silvio, here's my hand, and with it I give you my promise to be your wife.
And mine to be your husband.
Excellent. Now that it's promised, there's no going back on it.
Isn't that typical? I'm just dying to get married, and that's the second husband promised her in a week.
Rigoletta, Smiraldina, you two shall be witnesses to this betrothal. My daughter Clarice to Signor Silvio, the worthy son of our good friend Signora Lombardi.
It would be an honor and a privilege, sir.
No, no, it's only right. I was a witness at your wedding, and now you're a witness to my daughter's. Now, I know this announcement is a little quick. After all, her husband-to-be was just killed off. But you can't hold back, love. No, no. We'll just have a quiet dinner together. No one wants a great number of relatives eating us out of house and home. What do you say, my little lovebirds? Does that suit you?
Well, I desire nothing more than to be near my bride.
He'd like to skip dinner and go straight to dessert.
My son has no need for ceremony. He is honest and true and thinks of nothing but his love for your daughter.
Truly, this is a match made in heaven. Had it not been for the unfortunate demise of Federigo Rasponi, my rich correspondent at Torino, I promised my daughter to him, and he was quite a catch. A rich, rich, wealthy catch. But then I could not have given her to my dear son-in-law, Silvio.
I consider myself fortunate indeed, sir. I only hope that Clarice will say the same.
Oh, dear Silvio, you wrong me. You know I love you, and even if I had been forced to marry Signor Rasponi, in obedience to my father, my heart had still been yours.
Tis true indeed, the will of God is wrought in unexpected ways. Pray, sir,
The girl's lover fought a duel in defense of his sister's honor. He ran a sword through him, and that, as they say, was that.
Did this happen in Torino?
Right in the street.
Alas, I am sorry to hear it.
Did you know this Federigo Rasponi?
Indeed I did, sir. I was 3 years in Torino. I often saw his sister, too. A brave and spirited young lady, dressed like a man and rode a horseback. But her brother did his best to take care of her. Lord, who'd have thought it?
Well, tragedy can come to all of us. Best not dwell on it. Instead, Signora Brigoletta, why don't you show us your skill in the kitchen, make us a few of your special dishes?
'Twould be a pleasure. Though I say so myself, when you eat at my inn, you eat like a king. I shall make you something fine, sir.
Excellent. Just make sure there's something with a sauce so I can sop my bread in it. Oh, what's that?
It's a knock at the door.
Of course it's a knock at the door. Go and see who it is.
Me?
Goofy gentleman in the front row. Of course you.
Yes, sir.
Let's hope it's not the relatives looking for a free meal.
Daddy, may I be excused?
No, well, I'll go just as soon as we find out who's here. Those two doves can't be left alone for a while.
Sir, there's a servant to a gentleman in the street who desires to speak with you. He won't tell me a thing, but insists on speaking with my master.
Well, that's me. Let's hear what he has to say.
I'll show him in, sir. May I not go, Daddy?
And whither then, my girl?
I know not. To church?
No, young lady, no. You stay right here. Those two lovebirds can't be left alone for a second.
Indeed, prudence is the best part to virtue.
My most humble salutations to you, ladies and gentlemen. And a very fine company, too. The very breast of the breast.
Pray tell me, who are you, good man?
Who is this fair young maiden?
That is my daughter.
Delighted to hear it.
What's more, she is going to be married.
I'm sorry to hear it. And who might you be, fair lady?
I, sir, am the lady's maid.
I'm delighted again.
Come, sir, enough ceremony. Why do you watch? Who the devil are you and who is your master?
Patience, patience, my good sir, patience. Each question is a good question, but three at once is too much. As I am a simple man, could you take them one at a time?
The man's a fool.
I think he's playing the fool.
Now, was it you that was going to be married?
No, sir, my mistress.
Oh, mistress, that's right.
You can tell us who you are and we'll go about your business.
If you simply want to know who I am, sir, I'll tell you in two words. I am my master's sir. Now, where were we?
But who is your master?
He is a gentleman, sir, who would like to pay his respects to you. We have to have a little talk about this marriage thing I've been hearing so much about.
But who is this gentleman? What is his name?
Who, sir?
Your master.
Oh, that's an easy one. My master is Signor Federigo Rasponi of Torino, and he sends his greetings, and he has come to see you, and he's waiting in the street, and he sends me to say that he would like to come in, and he's waiting for an answer. Anything else? Or will that do? Let's start over.
What the devil did you say?
And since you are so interested, I am Truffaldino Butacchio from Bergamo.
Don't care who you are. Tell me again, what was your master's name? I fear I did not understand you rightly.
Poor old gentleman must be hard of hearing. My master is Signor Federigo Rasponi of Torino!
Wait, you madman! Federigo Rasponi is dead!
Dead?
Dead? Truly, he's dead. Worse luck for him.
The devil dead, my poor master! Why, I left him alive in the street! Are you sure that he's dead?
I tell you, he is absolutely, incontrovertibly dead.
I'm afraid it's true. We can have no doubt about it.
Alas, my good master, dead! This is terrible! Something awful must have happened! Your very humble servant, sir.
Can I do nothing more for you?
If he is dead, there's nothing more to do. But I'd better see if it's true or not.
What are we to make of this fellow? Is he a knave or a fool?
Perhaps a bit of both.
Well, he is from Bergamo. They're all knaves and fools there.
Well, I like that red-headed fellow.
But it can't really be Federigo Rasponi.
Well, if it isn't, it's the worst of news for me.
Oh, nonsense. You saw the letters that came. Federigo Rasponi is dead.
Even if he is alive, he's arrived too late.
Gentlemen! I am surprised at you! Is that the way to treat a poor man? Duped? Deluded? Is that the behavior of a gentleman? I demand satisfaction!
We must be careful, the man's mad! What on earth's the matter?
You told me my master was dead!
So he is!
And so he... He's here, out in the street, hale and hearty, and still waiting to pay his respects with your kind permission.
Signor Federigo?
Signor Federigo.
Rasponi?
Rasponi.
Of Torino?
Of course of Torino!
Go to the devil, my boy, you're mad!
The devil to you, sir! God! promised my mother I wouldn't swear.
I tell you he's here, out in the street, bad luck to you.
I won't stand for this in my own house, Wild.
No, no, Signor Pantalone. Let us have him bring in this person who we swear to Federico Rasponi, so we can see him with our own eyes.
I'll bring in this man you have raised from the dead.
He may have been dead and risen from the dead for all I know. That's none of my affair. But he's alive now, sure enough, as you shall see for yourself. And 'tis high time you learned to behave properly to strangers. You're just lucky I'm from Bergamo, where we've learned to turn the other cheek.
Young woman, we should have a little talk when you will.
Oh, Silvio, I'm all in trouble.
Don't worry, whatever happens, you are mine.
I must say, this is quite the quandary.
Some villain, I dare say, come to extort money from me.
Signor Pantalone, as I told you just now, I knew Signor Federigo Torino. We shall see if it is he.
Signor Pantalone! The courtesy I found in your correspondence is hardly matched by the treatment I received from you in person. I send my servant in to pay you my respects. You keep me standing in the street half an hour before you condescend to receive me.
Sir, I ask your pardon, but who are you?
Your humble servant, sir. Federigo Rasponi.
Of Torino?
Of Torino.
Extraordinary.
What can this mean? This is not Federigo, but his sister, Beatrice.
Well, sir, I rejoice to see you alive and in good health after the bad news which we have received.
I tell you, I don't believe it yet.
Indeed, 'twas reported I was killed in a duel. Heavens be praised, 'twas merely a flesh wound, and I no sooner regained my strength than set forth to Venezia to meet our previous arrangement.
Well, you have the appearance of an honest man, but until I have proof to the contrary, I must believe that Signor Federigo is dead.
You are right to be cautious in these dangerous times. I recognize I must give you proof of my identity. Here are four letters of introduction to correspondents known to you personally. One of them is the director of our bank. I expect these will satisfy you.
Oh, Silvio, we are lost!
I would rather lose my life before I lose you.
Heavens! Brigoletta! How the devil does she come to be here? If she betrays me...
Friend! I think I know you!
Indeed, sir. Brigoletta Camicchio of Torino.
Ah, yes, of course! And what brings you to Venezia, my good woman?
For the love of heaven, don't betray me.
Trust me. I keep the best in town, sir.
Ah, the very thing for me is I again have the pleasure of your acquaintance. I shall lodge at your inn.
You honor me, sir.
Well, the legends are in order if you present them, and I'm bound to believe that you are Federico Rasponi.
If you have any other doubts, allow Mistress Brigoletta to vouch that I am indeed a Rasponi.
That, I swear, is true.
Sir, I must ask your pardon for having doubted your word.
Well, this man is really Federigo Rasponi.
He is.
Alas, what shall become of us?
Don't be afraid. Nothing will tear us apart.
Well, Signora, just in time, I say.
Ah, sit in punto, quod non contingit in anno.
What?
Who is this young lady?
That is my daughter, Clarice.
The one promised to me in marriage.
The same.
Signorina Clarice, I am honored.
Your most humble servant.
She receives me somewhat coldly.
It's only that she's shy by nature.
And this gentleman, another relative of yours?
Why, yes, he's my nephew.
No, sir, I am not his nephew. I am the husband of Signorina Clarice.
Good boy, don't lose your chance. Stand up for your rights, but be careful.
How can this be, Signor? She not promised to me?
Let me explain. Oh, my dear Signor Rasponi, I was convinced of your sad and tragic demise, and therefore promised my daughter to Signor Silvio. You have arrived just in time, and I will keep my word, and Clarice is yours, if you will have her. My dear Signor Silvio, I don't know what to say. You can see my predicament. You have no cause to bear me ill will.
Surely, sir, Signor Federico will not take the bride when we've already given her hand.
But her dowry is still intact, and I am not one to quibble. I must keep up appearances. Besides, there might be some fun in it.
There's a fine, fashionable husband. I like him.
I trust Signorina Clarice will not refuse my hand.
But sir, Clarice is to be mine. I will never yield her to you. If you wrong me, Signor Pantalone, I will have my revenge.
And any man who attempts to steal Clarice from me must reckon with my sword.
That's a fine boy, by God.
Thank you, but I don't mean to die just yet.
With all respect, sir, you are too late. Signorina Clarice is to marry my son. The law, sir, the law is clear upon that point. Priore tempore, but so I do it. I love you.
And to you, good lady bride, do you say nothing?
I say, sooner marry the hangman.
You insolent!
affections in time. Meanwhile, let us go over our accounts, for our business arrangements must be sorted out, whatever occurs.
You'll find everything in order, I'm certain. The money is ready for you, and we'll make up the accounts whenever you like.
I will call on you once I'm settled in. Now, if you excuse me, I will go with Mr. Sprigaletta to her inn.
As you wish, sir. And remember, I'm at your service if you have need of anything.
Well, if you could loan me a little money, I'd be greatly obliged. I didn't bring any with me for fear of being robbed along the way.
I'd be delighted, but my cashier is not here just now. The moment he returns, I will send the money to your lodgings at Rigoletta's later.
Thank you, but I'll just send my servant. He's honest. You can trust him with anything.
Sir, you are asked for.
Well, who is it?
I couldn't say, sir.
I will come directly. Sir, I must ask your pardon. Rigoletta, remember, you are a cashier. Be good enough to attend Signor Federigo.
Pray, do not put yourself about for me, sir.
I must go now. Farewell, sir.
May I ask, Signorina Beatrice?
Hush, for the love of heaven, don't betray me. My poor brother is dead. My lover, Florindo, killed him in a duel over me. They fought. Federigo fell, and Florindo fled from justice. My brother was bound from Venezia to marry Clarice, so I took his clothes and the letters of recommendation. With the money I'll get from Pantalone, I'll try to find Florindo. Be my friend, dear Brigoletta. Please don't give me away. You'll be generously rewarded.
That's all very well. But I don't want to be responsible for Signor Pantalone being swindled out of his money.
Swindled? If my brother is dead, am I not his heir?
Very true. Why not just say so?
If I do that, I can do nothing. Pantalone will start clucking over me like a mother hen. Will peg me up and send me home. I need my freedom, however brief it might be. Help me to it. Twill not last long.
Well, you always wear spirits, young lady. Trust me, I shall do my best for you.
Thank you. Now shall we go to your inn?
What about your servant?
I told him to wait for me in the street.
Where on earth did you find that fool?
I picked him up on my journey. He seems a fool at times, but I can rely on his loyalty.
Well, that's something. The things we do for love, eh, Signora Sponi?
Love can make us do much more and much worse.
Well, if we go on that way, Lord knows we can come of it.
I'm sick of this. I can't wait any longer. This master of mine never provides enough to eat, and the less he gives me, the more I want. Every time the town clock strikes, my belly rings out a response.
Shh! Easy, boy. Serve your neighbors.
I swear, I could die of starvation and never notice. If I only knew where we were going to stay. My other masters, when they came to a new town, the first thing they did was find an inn, put their feet up, and have a nice meal. Maybe a drink or two. This new gentleman of mine can't be bothered. Oh, Lord, no! He leaves his luggage at the dock, goes off on his crazy business, and forgets all about his poor servant. You know, when they tell us to serve our masters with love, they should tell the masters to be kind to the servants. Well, here's an inn. You know, I have half a mind to go in and see if I can fill my belly. But what if my other master comes and looks for me? Well, his own fault. He doesn't know better. I'm going in. But now I think of it, I haven't a penny. A wishing well. I see something shiny at the bottom. Oh, it's in my reach, too. Do you gentlemen have any money at all?
We're musicians.
Oh, yeah. If only there were a large group of people who were dumb enough to be swindled out of their own money. Hey! Hi! Hey, you! Remember me? We did that thing back then and that. Anyways, do you have any money at all? I mean, a pinch. Yeah, I'd like to. Sure you would. Please, hey, would you like to see a dance? I can do a jig.
Would you like to see a jig? All right, here we go.
Yeah! Oh, poor Truffaldino. I wasn't born to be a servant. Devil take me. I should have been something else. For the love of heaven, there's nothing else you can do.
Sorry, I can't go any further.
Can't you carry a few more steps there?
let you out, sir. See how I do it.
Well done.
It weighs nothing, sir. A mere trifle, a breeze, a piece of cake. Nothing but the puff of wind on my shoulder.
See?
My name to the waiter and you'll be served like a king.
What's your name?
Truffaldino Mutacchio from Bergamo.
And what's your trade?
Service, sir.
And have you a master?
At the moment, to tell you the truth, I have not.
You're without a master.
You see me, sir? I'm without a master. My master's not here, so I tell him all lies.
You want to be my servant?
Well, why not? If his terms are better, how much would you give me?
How much do you want?
Well, my other master, I mean the one I used to work for, he paid me a ducat a day.
Good, I'll give the same.
Of course, a man must look to improve his lot in life.
How much more do you want?
Perhaps a sandwich every now and then?
Fine, a ducat a day and 3 square meals.
Four
then.
Now that's a master worth serving. I'm your man, sir.
Would I like to know some more about you? Some references.
If you want to know all about me, just go to Bergamo. Anyone there will tell you who I am.
There's no one in Venezia who knows you?
I've just arrived this morning, sir.
Well, you seem fair. I'll give you a trial.
I won't let you down.
First, I'm anxious to know whether there are any letters waiting for me to post. Here's some money. Go and see if there are letters for Arthus. Fluendor Arthus. Bring them here at once.
Well, what about lunch, sir?
Well said. I will order lunch while you're at the post. Cheeky fellow, but I like.
A ducat a day, that's twice what I was getting from my other gentleman. I think. When opportunity knocks, just open the door, my mother used to say. Since my other master's nowhere to be found, he may go about his business. I'm off to the post for my new master.
And where are you off to? I told you to wait for me.
Oh, I'm just stretching my legs. Oh, feel that burn, yeah.
Now am I to find you if you go traipsing about town every 5 minutes? Tis a mere accident I found you here this time.
I'm just trying to stave off my hunger, sir.
Well, if you want any lunch at all, you'll fetch my trunk from the landing stage. Take it to the inn, Mr. Sprigoletto.
Devil! That one there?
Yes, that one there. And while you're about to go to the post and ask if there are any letters for me, in fact, you should ask if there are any letters for my sister, Beatrice Risponi. Some friend of hers might perhaps write, so be sure and see if there are any letters for either her or for me.
What am I to do?
If you left home secretly, why do you expect letters in your real name?
I asked my steward to send me any news that might help me, and I don't know which name he may use. Truffaldino, make haste. Fetch the letters and take the trunk to the inn. I shall be there.
Yes, sir. Are you the innkeeper?
Yes, I am. Do as he says, and I'll make sure you're fed well when you get back.
There's luck! There are some who look in vain for a master, and I have found two! What the devil am I to do? I cannot wait upon them both. No? Well, why not? If I wait upon them both, I'll earn two men's wages, and two men's suppers! 'Twould be a fine thing indeed, if neither one found out. Of course. What is that? Is that a cellular telephone? Oh, that did not just go off in front of me! Well, that's worse than breaking wind in front of your own mother, which I'm sure you're guilty of too, sister! Give me it! No, Rocco! Cell phone! Get up! I'm not joking! You know what to do. Get up! Stand, now! This is what you get! This is what you get!
Kiss it goodbye,
okay? Walk the line, sister.
Here comes the pain! Stay out! Mr. Brigham, please make sure all telephones are empty.
Right then, two masters. If it lasts but a day, I'll try. Now I'm off to the post for both of them.
There's time, sir. My good man!
Me, sir.
Where's your master?
Oh, my master. He's in that inn.
Well,
Go and get him. Tell him that I wish to speak with him.
Oh, but sir.
Go at once.
But sir, I must tell you, my master.
He be a man of honor. Let him come down. I wait on him.
But which one do you want?
Go now. I should beat you black and blue.
Okay. I'll find him. Send the first I can find.
No, I will never suffer a rival. Federigo may have escaped once with his life, but he will not always be so lucky. Either he shall renounce all claims to Clarice, or he shall give me satisfaction. Now, who is this?
There's the peppery gentleman.
I've never seen him before. What does he want?
I don't know. I'll go fetch the letters with your leave, sir. I'm not getting mixed up in this.
Federigo does not come.
I must discover the truth. Sir, are you the gentleman who called on me?
Oh, I, sir, have not even the honor of your acquaintance.
But my servant told me you may both challenge me.
He was mistaken. I wish to speak with his master.
Very well, I am his master.
You, sir?
Indeed.
Well, then I must beg your forgiveness. For either your servant looks exactly like another, or he waits on someone else.
You may ease your mind, he waits on me.
Well, then I once again humbly beg your forgiveness.
Go home, dog. These things happen.
Are you a stranger here, sir?
From Torino, sir, at your service.
Marvelous, and I sought you from Torino.
Then perhaps I may know him. If he has given offense, I shall gladly assist you in seeking satisfaction.
Well, do you know that one Federigo Rasponi?
I knew him all too well.
He makes a claim on some previous contract to take my Clarice, who only this morning swore to be my wife.
Let me ease your fears. Federico Rasponi cannot take your wife from you. He is dead.
So we all thought, but this morning, to my disgust, he arrived in Venezia very much alive.
Sir, you petrified me.
I was petrified myself.
But I assure you Federico Rasponi is dead.
And I assure you that Federico Rasponi is alive.
You must be mistaken.
Signor Pantalone Pennypinza, my fiancé's father, has made all possible inquiries to assure himself that Federico is here in person.
That he was not killed by a blade, but indeed.
Now he must either renounce claims to Clarice or to his life.
Federico, here.
I'm surprised you have not seen him. He was alive at his very end.
I haven't seen a soul. They told me there were no guests here.
He may have changed his mind. But I again ask your pardon. If you do see Federico, please persuade him for his own welfare to renounce all claims to Clarice. I am Silvio Lombardi, and your most obedient
servant. I have the honor of your friendship, sir.
On your name, sir?
I must have discovered myself. My name is Vendice Pronto, sir.
Signor Pronto, I'm yours to command.
How can this be? I felt my sword pierce his heart, yet it was dark. Perhaps I fled so quickly I was mistaken. Well, since he is alive, I must go back to Torino to console my beloved Beatrice, who is perhaps suffering from my absence.
Yes!
I must try to Torino without delay.
Torino!
Here, sir.
We must save for Torino.
When?
Now what?
Before lunch?
No, we eat quickly and then.
Eating too quickly might cause you indigestion. It's better to eat slowly and relax and enjoy the repast. You must chew each by 25 times, mother.
Never mind, have you been to the post?
Yes, sir.
Have you found my letters?
I have, sir.
Where are they?
Here, sir! The devil! I mixed up one master's letters with the other, and I don't know which is which. I knew I should have learned to read!
Come, give me my letters.
Directly, sir. Here's a muddle. I must tell you, sir, that these three letters are not all for your honor.
What do you mean?
Well, a funny thing happened on my way to the post. You see, I met another servant I knew from Bergamo, which is where I'm from, and I told him I was going to the post. And he said, really? Well, would you mind getting a letter from my master? And I said, yes, yes, I would mind, but I did it anyway. And one of these was his, and I don't know which it was.
Come, give me letters. I'll take mine and give you the other back.
There, sir. Just doing a favor for a friend.
What's this? Bad creature of phone? Bad creature Sponi Venezia.
Well, that one must be for my mate.
Who is this mate of yours?
He is a servant, sir. His name is Pasquale.
And who is he, sir?
I don't know.
Then how are you to the letters?
Oh, right, sir. The devil.
What's the name?
It slipped in my mind.
What mind?
He wrote it down on a bit of paper.
And where is the paper?
I must have left it at the post. I'll just go get it. Everything will be all right. I'm learning my part as I go along.
Where does this fellow Pasquale live?
Indeed, sir. I haven't the slightest idea.
Then how are you to give him the letters?
He said I should meet him in the piazza, which is this way. I'll just go and clear this up. And
I don't know what to make of it.
Pray, sir, give me the letters and I shall find him.
No, no. I will open this letter.
No, don't do that, sir. You know I'm wrong in selling letters.
This letter is addressed to someone who has a certain claim. I can open it without scruple.
Okay. You just opened someone else's letter. Can you do that?
Your departure from the city has given rise to much
talk. You see this?
Fraud!
That's right.
The Court of Justice has discovered that you are barred in a man's dress and intends to have you arrested.
That's against the law.
I have sent this letter to a friend in Genoa, so as not to reveal whether you were bound. If I have any more news, I'll send it by the same agent, his humble servant Antonio.
Yeah, that's a nice way to behave, reading other people's letters.
Beatrice has left home and man's supposed to find me? Indeed, she loves me. Heaven grant me I find her here in Venezia. My good Cialdino, go and do all you can. Find Pasquale, find out who he serves and where he lives. And if you can, bring him here. Both you and Pasquale will be most handsomely rewarded.
Well, if the reward includes lunch, I'll do my best to find him, sir.
This letter is of infinite importance to me, so do not fail.
But am I to give him the letter openly, miss?
Don't be difficult. Tell him there's an accident or something.
Then we're not out to Torino now?
No, not for the present. Lose no time. Go and find Pasquale.
Yes, sir.
Bad bridge in Venezia. Fight the big of Venezia. Okay. If her brother finds her unhappy woman, I must do all I can to discover her first.
Upon my word, I hope to stay in Venezia. I want to see how my two jobs will work out. This double service thing could be very rewarding. Right then, this letter. I don't want to give to my other master open. I must fold it away so he doesn't notice. There, now it just has to be sealed. How do I manage that? I once had a friend who used to seal letters with gum. He was a little, you know, in the head, but hey, it might work. Does anyone have a stick of gum? Is anyone carrying gum on them right now? Anyone at all, please? Anyone chewing anything? Ooh. Oh, you don't have a plate, do you? Oh, yes, thank you. Oh, yeah. Oh, that looks fine. It's minty. Oh, I forgot about the trunk!
Is that my trunk?
Yes, sir, I think so.
Have you been to the post?
I have, sir.
Any letters for me?
None for you, but one for your sister.
Sister? Oh, right, that's me. Give it to me at once. This letter has been opened.
Open? No, get out of here.
Yes, open! It's sealed with gum!
I can't imagine how that could happen.
It's like Rassel, who opened this letter. I must know!
Sir, sir, I'll tell you. I'll confess. We all make mistakes, and there's a letter in the post for me. Since I can't read, I opened yours by mistake. I beg your pardon, sir. Please beat me if you have to. Flog me, hang me, throw and torture me.
Well, I suppose there's no harm done.
This is true. I'm a word of a poor man.
Have you read this letter? Do you know what it says?
Not a word. I can't read the handwriting.
Has anyone else seen it?
Oh!
Take care now.
Sir!
Listen, I have some business to attend to. Take my trunk. Here's my key.
Here's your
and I'll pack my things. Get it?
Got it.
Good. When I come back, we'll have dinner.
Dinner?
I need to find Signor Pantalone and the money he owes me.
I don't know how I do it.
I think I should ask for more money.
Tell me, my good man, is your master in the inn?
No, sir.
Do you know where he's gone?
I'm not bad either.
Will he be back for dinner?
I certainly hope so.
Then make sure he gets these as soon as he returns. That's 100 ducats. I cannot stay, so make sure you give it to him a good day.
And a good day to you, sir. Oh, wait! Wait! You never told me what to my master's I was to give it. Sir!
So, have you found that fellow with small
head? No, sir, but I found a man who gave me a 100 ducats.
100 ducats? What for?
Well, tell me, sir, were you expecting money from anyone?
I presented a letter of exchange to a merchant this morning.
Well, then this money will be for you.
And what did he say when he gave it to you?
He told me to give it to my master.
Not your master.
Well, what about the other one?
No, don't forget Pasquale.
I'm afraid I'm too faint with hunger to travel another step, sir.
Very well. We'll go and eat lunch, but then you go and find Pasquale.
Very good, sir. Well, at least I did something right today. I gave the purse to the right master.
In Napoli, where love is blind, when boy meets girl, here's what they say. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When you walk down the street with the clouds at your feet, you're in love.
That's the long and the short of it. Signor Federico Rastoni is to be your husband, so stop your weeping. I've given my word and that's an end to it.
But Daddy, this is Terry!
You were quite happy when Signor Federico first asked for your hand. You should have spoken then, for now it's too late.
But I only consented out of respect to you.
Then why refuse me now?
Because I cannot marry him.
No, and why not?
Nothing shall make me marry Federico.
And what's wrong with him?
He is odious in my eyes.
What if I were to show you how you might begin to like Signor Federico? He has his... Good point.
But I'm sworn to Silvio!
Put Senor Silvio out of your mind and you will soon like Federigo well enough.
Silvio is too firmly stamped upon my heart. My entire world is Silvio! And you yourself approved him.
Well, now I am disapproving him. In some ways, I am sorry for the girl. You must make a virtue of necessity.
My heart is not capable of such betrayal.
Come, come, it won't be so hard.
Sir? Signor Federigo Rasponi. And the dying. Wait until all the financial arrangements are out of the way.
Oh, don't worry. We'll have that sorted out in no time.
Daddy, I beg you.
No more. I'm going straight away to say a word to Signor Silvio.
Cruel old husband! Do not anger him!
What? Do you want two husbands?
Not exactly, but...
But me no buts. Tis all settled. Your servant, sir.
Listen, sir!
Your husband and wife.
But Daddy!
We will talk about it tonight.
Oh, Senorita Beatrice, it's worse than before. Shall I never be happy?
Mother, leave me alone. Intolerable insult!
But you cannot do this at Lord Pantalone's own house! You are being foolish!
It is he that makes fools of us, and therefore he deserves no civility.
Yes, and there is no reason to be rash. Leave him to me, my dear
boy, leave him to me. I will bring him to reason and make him see where his duty lies.
Go away with me. I will for Signor Pantalone.
My
son! Do as I say.
Fine. I'll go, but if Pantalone persists, you will have to settle with me.
Oh, my poor boy. I feel truly sorry for him. Signor Pantalone ought to have ensured Federigo's morbidity before leading my son on. But rational and objective discussion will put things right.
What is Signora Lombardi doing outside my house?
Oh, Signor Pantalone, my respects.
Your servant, Signora. I was just coming to look for you and your son.
Indeed. Good. I expect you were hurrying to ensure us that Louis Table indeed marry Silvio.
Well, actually, I was just coming to tell you that.
No need for explanation. You have my sympathies in a very awkward situation. A delicate and difficult dilemma, to be sure. A conundrum. But a dilemma, if you will, perhaps. Even an embroglio. But we all friends, let bygones be bygones.
Yes, of course, but a promise was made to Signor Federigo.
No. But Signor Federigo took you by surprise. He gave you no time for reflection. You had no chance to consider the
affront you were giving our family.
You can hardly talk of an affront when a previous contract...
No need to continue. I know exactly what you are about to say. It seemed, at first, that the contract of the gentleman was binding, a priori, and therefore could not be repudiated.
Whereas with our contract, as you have seen through greater reflection, takes precedence, having ratification, if you will, by the tendering of the young lady's hand.
Very true, but...
And as you would no doubt say yourself, consensus et non concubitus, facit virum.
No doubt, if I was a Latin scholar, but in plain language...
Truly, the girl must not be satisfied.
Have you finished?
I have finished.
You're done.
I have nothing more to say.
May I... Speak, my dear Signora, with all your legal
but
learning.
It's a dowry. We won't quibble. What have you done is here and there between friends?
I must begin all over. Will you allow me to speak?
Certainly.
My dear Signora, I have the greatest respect for your legal learning, but in this case it does not apply.
Then you mean to tell me that this other marriage is to take place?
I was just coming to tell you this, that my daughter's agreed consensus whatchamacallit, so what impediment can there be? I'm extremely sorry, but there's nothing I can do.
I tell you, Signor Pantalone, I am not surprised at your little slut of a daughter's behavior! The minx! But I am aghast that you, sir, should treat me in this disgraceful manner. If you were not perfectly certain that Federigo Rasponi was dead and buried, then you should not have entered into an engagement with my son. But having begun that engagement, you are bound to maintain it, whatever it might cost you. The news of Federigo's death was quite sufficient to justify a change of plans, even to Federigo. Coram testibus, sir, coram testibus. I should insist upon the annulment of a contract with Federigo and compel your daughter to marry my son. But I will not sully my family with a harlot like your daughter, the daughter of a man who breaks his word as you do.
Signor Pantalone, you have done me an injury and slandered the house of Lombardi!
I will come.
Yes, sir, the time will come.
Omnia! Tempus! Omnia!
You may go to the devil for all I care, you overeducated yeti! There is no
Your servant, sir.
Your servant, sir. He is hotter than Japanese horseradish.
I've just heard something from my mother, and I can believe it to be true.
Oh, well, if your mother said it, it must be true.
Well, then this marriage between Signor Federigo and Signorina Clarice still stands.
Yes, sir, signed and sealed.
Then you, sir, are a man of no reputation. You are, in fact, a gentleman.
How dare you speak that way to men of my age and standing?
Well, I don't care who you are, just run through.
Do you think me a frog to be spitted by a spoiled brat? You should be ashamed to come to my house and make all this turmoil.
Well, if you be a man of honor, then come with me to the field of battle.
I'm surprised at you, sir. I'm accustomed to be treated with respect.
You, sir, are a low villain. Low, low person and a coward.
And you, sir, are a most impertinent little imp.
Swear by the devil!
Help! Murder!
He's crazy! He's crazy!
He's crazy! He's crazy! He's crazy!
Ha! I shall defend you!
My dear son-in-law!
Just the man I wish to fight!
I'm in for it now!
Come on, sir!
Careful!
Don't worry. It's not the first time I've been in danger. Here you are. Thank you. Come on, sir! Do go first! I hear no
news. Ha!
That's right, Sonny, give me a 1-2. Who's strong as the force in that one?
Thank you.
point was nowhere near her heart.
Have you ever heard such a lie?
It was just ready to hit her!
You women are always getting hysterical!
Hysterical? Unbelievable. Look, the only reason you men can keep giving women the shaft is because we don't have one.
But they never say a word about the men. We get all the blame, and you are allowed to do as you please. Yeah, you. Do you know why? Do you know why?
Why?
Because the men have made the laws. If the women had made them, things would be the other way around. And then, no woman would put up with you, pouting and prancing about like the silly little baby you are. They pull out a diaper and give you the spanking you deserve!
Well, women are all in this together. Clergy was only pretending suicide to move my compassion. Clergy faithless. Clergy traitorous. But though fate made me fall this time, I will have my revenge. The wretch will die, and clergy will see her lover wallowing in his own blood.
Just my luck! Two masters and neither one comes home to eat. It's been hours and neither wants to be found.
Oh, sure enough, they'll both come back at the same time and I'll have to wait on both together and the whole thing will be found out. I'll speak of the devil. Here comes one. Now we can eat.
So, have you found that fellow, Pasquale?
Didn't we say something else to look for after he ate?
I must see him! Well, I'm not hungry. I should go to the post. Maybe then I can find out something.
Sir, Benicio, you must eat. The water will make you sick. I've seen it happen.
I really must go. If I come back for dinner, well, good. If not, I shall eat in the evening.
You can get some food yourself if you like.
Very good, sir. Just as you please, sir. You're the master.
Take this purse. It's far too heavy to carry around. Put it in my trunk. Here's the key.
Very, sir. I'll give you the key back at once.
No, you keep. I really must be going. If I don't come back for dinner, you meet me in the piazza. I can't rest until I find Pasquale.
Well, you did say I could give myself something to eat. We are agreed upon that. He may not be hungry, but my complexion wasn't made for fasting.
Topolino!
Yeah.
Did Signor Pantalone Penipizza give you a purse of 100 ducats?
Oh, yes, indeed he did.
Then why didn't you give it to me?
Was it meant for your honor?
Was it meant for me? What did he say when he gave you the purse?
He told me to give it to my master.
And who is your master?
You are.
Then why do you ask if the purse is mine?
Can't be too careful.
Where is it? Is all the money here?
I never touched it, sir.
I shall count it.
Well, I made a mistake over the purse, but I wonder what my other master will say. Oh, well, if the money wasn't his, he'll say nothing at all.
Is the innkeeper about?
Yes, sir.
Tell her I will have a friend to dine with me, so I have a few extra dishes.
A man after my own heart. How many extra dishes?
Oh, Signor Pantalone's not a glutton. 5 or 6 between us. Just make them tasty.
And you leave it all to me?
Yes. Do the best you can. I'm going to fetch Signor Pantalone. Make sure all is right by the time we come back.
You shall see how they serve you here.
Oh, and take this paper and put it in my trunk. Be very careful with it. 'Tis a bill of exchange for 4,000 crowns.
And be sure of it, sir. I'll give it my utmost care.
Poor old Pantalone, he had a terrible fright. I'll have to check, cheer him up a little.
Now's the time to display my fine sense of foodery, to show what I can do when ordering a dinner. I'll just put away this paper and no. I'll put it away later. I mustn't waste time. Hold there, Mr. Sprigoletto! Mr. Sprigoletto, I want to talk to you. Now, a really good dinner, it's not on many dishes, but the way they are served, presentation is everything. Mr. Sprigoletto, yeah, jeez!
What is it, Signor Topolino?
My master is entertaining a gentleman and requests an enormous amount of food prepared immediately. Have you got enough in the food chest?
My chest is always stacked.
Indeed. What do you suggest?
For two gentlemen, we shall have 2 courses of 2 dishes.
Well, he said 5 or 6 dishes. Better say 6 or 8.
Very well. For the first course, I shall give you zuppa.
Oh.
Polenta.
Oh.
Holpi.
Oh, yeah.
And perhaps some baduzzi veneziana.
What? The 3 of the dishes I know, I do not know the last.
A specialty of mine, meatballs lovingly slathered in sauce.
That'll do for the first course, and now the second?
For the second course, I shall give you Ossibuco, Himaduare.
Oh, yes.
Arrosto Morto.
Oh, yeah.
And to finish it off, I always get compliments on my peaches.
I bet you do.
I take two fuzzy peaches, rub them lightly, slowly peel back the skin. I remove the pit to reveal a hole that needs filling. I take some fresh cream, whip it gently, and carefully squeeze it into the center of the peach.
Go on. I dare say. We'll do. But how are you going to arrange the table?
That's easy enough. The way you'll just set things out.
Oh, no. Laying the table is extremely important. I'm a stickler for the look of a table.
Very well. Then we should put the polenta there. There the poppy. Here the nuzzi, and there the zuppa.
But what about something in the middle?
Then we should add another dish.
Mama!
Who has to put the zuppa de carne, the gravy, in the middle?
No. You can't put gravy in the middle. Zuppa always goes in the middle.
Then the meat on one side.
No, we could not! What an absolute outrage! The meat on one side, the gravy on the other. You may know how to cook, Signora, but you have no idea of butlering. Now, I'll show you. First, we put the zuppa in the middle. Here, we put the pulpy. We put the polenta opposite of the pulpy. Here, the arrosto. And here, the gravy. Won't that look fine?
Twill do, but the arrosto is too far away from the gravy.
Very well. We'll just squeeze them together a little bit.
What are you doing?
Nothing, just a little culinary creativity.
What's that paper?
Oh!
That's the good one!
Brick! More gum!
You moron! Is that how you look after my things? You deserve a good passion! What say you, Signor Captain Lombay?
I'm truly sorry, I can't help laughing. Don't worry, I'll manage not another than I'll be in order.
But just think if we'd not been here but someplace a long way off. You moron! My dad's gonna help! Look at him!
This is all because Brigada doesn't know how to lay a table! Just like a woman!
Just like a woman! Indeed! Just like a woman! Truffaldino, go make sure my room is in order.
But things must be done properly.
Be off, I tell you.
In the matter of picture work, I won't give way to the first butler in the land!
Go away!
Fine. But don't blame me. If you can't reach the gravy!
I can't make sense of it. One minute he's as sharp as a gorgonzola, the next he's lost in the spaghetti.
You keep mentioning food. Is dinner ready?
Five dishes to each course, it'll take some time.
Five dishes, courses? No. At least I'll just take a little potluck. A couple of dishes with a nice risotto and I shall be most happy.
Very well, sir, but is there anything you would particularly fancy?
Well, I should like something with some risoles, if you have them. Something nice and soft.
You hear risoles.
Very good. Make yourselves comfortable at this table, gentlemen, and dinner will be right out.
Tell Truffaldino to come and wait on us.
Their funeral.
Signor Pantalone, I hope you'll be content with such a meager meal.
Oh, no, I am overcome with all the attention you show me, my dear young man. It should be me buying you dinner at my house, but as you insist, and we go on.
At a time. Yeah, you don't get much for your money in here. Wonder what it tastes like.
At your service, sir.
For God's sake, put it on the table. I would less gymnastics, more attention. Where is that?
Wait here, what do you got for me?
Here's somebody.
Oh, Dootsie. What? Oh, maybe horse.
No, dead pork are very good too.
What the devil are you doing?
Nothing. I was just laying the table for you, sir.
Before I come back, you're gonna just blind in the head. And you bring the meat before the zuppa?
Oh, when you're the pizza, you always have the zuppa after the meat is done.
I don't care. Take that back to the kitchen. I want my zuppa.
Right away, sir.
And be quick about it, too. I just want to look by. Don't take that.
Yes, sir.
Shall I ever send my band to the check-in?
No.
Truldino, I'm all host. We kept
I don't want some.
Right on.
There it is. Rigoletta's in.
A very proper business, this. Sending a young girl like me out all alone to a tavern. I'm not going inside. I'll call. Someone will come out. Hey there, anyone at home?
Hello, hello, hello. What can I do for you?
This is so embarrassing. Does the Signor Federigo Rasponi lodge here?
Yes, indeed. He is just finished his dinner.
I have a message for him.
A message? Come on inside, gorgeous.
And what sort of a girl do you take me for? I am the waiting maid of the lady he is to marry.
Well then, pray step this way.
I'm not going in there.
You want me to pull him on the street for you? Though that would hardly be the right thing, since he has Signor Pantalone Penne Pizza with
him. Oh, my master! I'll not come in!
I can send his servant if you like.
That red-headed fellow?
That's him.
Yes, do send him out.
A whitehead? Too shy to come inside but to talk to anyone on the street? I know your type.
Pig! Now, if Pantalone sees me, I'll just tell him I came to look for him. That'll be nicely. I'm never short of an answer.
Was it you who called?
It was. I'm sorry to trouble you.
Well, not at all. I'm here to receive your command.
I took you away from dinner.
It'll wait.
I am truly sorry.
I'm truly delighted. The fact is, I've had my fill, and your bright eyes are just the right thing to make me digest it.
Very gallant.
I'll just set down this bottle, and I'm with you, my dear.
He called me, my dear. My mistress sends this letter to Signor Federigo Rasponi. Thought that you might deliver it for me.
I'll do so with pleasure. But first, I have a message for you.
From whom?
From a very distinguished gentleman. Tell me, are you acquainted with one Truffaldino Buttacchio?
Perhaps, but I'm not sure. It must be himself.
A very handsome fellow, about 5'11", with red flowing hair, knows his way around the table.
Well, I don't know anyone like that.
Oh, yes, you do. And what's more, he's in love with you.
Oh, don't make fun of me.
And if there's some hope that his affections were returned, he would make himself known to you.
Well, sir, if I were to see him, and he caught my heart, I might possibly return his affection.
Shall I introduce you, then?
If you want.
Just a moment.
Oh, then 'tis not he.
I need you now.
Cheeks left all four of them.
Oh. I think it's a love letter.
Well, I'm not getting in any more trouble. If I don't know for certain what's in it, I'm not taking it.
We could open it, but how are we to seal it again?
You leave that to me. I've mastered the art of sealing letters. No one will be the wiser.
Go on, then.
Can you read?
A little, but you can read quite well, I'm sure.
Yes, I too can read.
Well, let's hear it then.
We need to bring ourselves any cleaning.
Quick, read it!
No, the lady first.
No, really, I can't make out a word.
Open up.
Then what was the good in opening it?
Well, let's see if we can make out some of them.
Well, I know some of the letters.
Let's take it one by one. Isn't that an M?
Nope, it's an R.
Quite similar, aren't they?
Read!
Lift with your knees. There you go. Bob a little bit. Nice.
keep my eye on.
You can do it. Put your back into it. You can do it. Put your back into it. Put your back in there.
Right, we're finished. You can run along now.
Now that no one's bothering me, I can do my work properly in peace and quiet. Now, which trunk does this key fit? I guessed right. I might be the smartest man on earth, and this one will open the other trunk. Brilliant! Now they're both open! Let's take everything out. Boy, there sure is a lot of junk in this trunk.
Are you certain that the gentleman is dead?
Completely, sir.
How did he die?
Oh, well,
Well, he met with an accident, and that was the end of him. Seems to be the best way out. Tell me, can you tell me where he was buried? Oh, wasn't ready for that one. He wasn't buried, sir.
What?
No, sir. Another servant had him put into a coffin and sent home.
And was this the same servant who got so fast the letter from the post this morning?
The very same. It was Pasquale! Then all hope is lost. Man, Felice's dead. The torches of her journey must have broken her heart and killed her. Oh, I can no longer endure the agony of my grief. Oh, unhappy Man, Felice!
Well, I bet
you'd be strung
by
our
for more trouble. Oh!
I assure you, Signor Capitano, the last shipment has been listed twice over.
Perhaps my young man made a mistake. Don't worry, we'll go through the books again and figure out where things stand.
I will listen to my records. We'll compare them and sort it out in no time. Truffaldino!
Here, sir.
Do my trunk key.
Yes, sir.
Why is my trunk out here?
Oh, I was just about to hurt your clothes.
Whose trunk is that?
Oh, that belongs to another traveler. Just arrived.
Well, fetch my memorandum book for me.
Yes, sir. God save me this time.
As I say, they may have made a mistake. It's so hard to find good help these days.
We may find all is in order. We shall see.
Is this a book, sir?
I expect so. No. This book isn't mine. Whose book is it?
I trouble Dino being of sound mind.
These are the letters I wrote to Florindo. These notes, these accounts belong to him.
What's wrong? Are you unwell?
Nothing, I assure you. Truffaldino, how did this book get into my trunk?
I don't know,
tell
sir.
Tell me the truth, out with it.
Please forgive me, sir, for putting the book into your trunk. It belongs to me, and I hid it there for safety. Worked with the last one.
And you didn't realize you were giving me your own book?
Clever, this one. I tell you, sir, I haven't had it for very long, so it was unfamiliar.
How did you get the book?
I was in service with another gentleman here, and then he died and left the book to me.
How long ago?
Oh, not long, about 10 or 12 days.
But I met you in Verona 10 days ago.
True, I just left Verona on account of the grief for my poor master.
Alas, my heart. Your master, was his name Florindo?
Florindo it was, sir.
Florindo, are you—
That's him.
Are you sure he's dead?
Oh, as sure as I stand here, sir.
How did he die? Where was he buried?
Well, he was walking one day, and he tumbled into the canal, knocked his head on a gondola, and drowned of an instant. He was never seen again.
Oh, wretch that I am! Florindo dead? My beloved dead? My one and only hope gone? All his lost love has vanished from the world. I leave my home. I dress as a man. I confront danger. I hazard my very life all for Florindo.
Gentleman is not the gentleman from Torino.
He may be from where he will. Your daughter has been seen with him at Hoxsufficient. I won't hear another word.
Then 'twill be the worse for you.
We shall see for whom it will be the worst.
My daughter is a girl of untarnished reputation.
The devil take you!
The devil take you, madam.
You disreputable old poop!
Damn the woman. All her learning and not a bit of sense. Why, how could I ever tell her that Signor Federico was actually a woman? Now here comes the other hothead herself.
There he is. Oh, I should like to run my sword through his belly.
Signor Silvio, allow me to give you a piece of good news.
What can that be?
You must know, sir, that my daughter's marriage to Signor Federico has come to nothing.
Do not deceive me, old man.
Tis true, and if you are still of the inclination, my daughter is ready to give you her hand whenever you please.
Oh, heaven! Oh, I'm resurrected!
Well, he's not quite such the bear as his mother.
How can I take her who belongs along with the bride of another?
To cut a long story short, the person we assumed to be Signor Federico Rasponi was actually his sister, Beatrice.
What?
I don't get it.
Thick-headed, isn't he? The person we assumed to be Signor Federico was actually his sister, Beatrice, in disguise.
Dressed as a man?
Dressed as a man. He's a quick one, all right.
Finally, I get it!
About time.
Well, how did it happen?
We'll go to my house. My daughter knows nothing of the story yet. I'll tell it to you together.
Well, I will gladly go with you, sir. But first, I must humbly beg your forgiveness, as I was rather transported by my passion.
Ha ha! 'Twas nothing. I know the hot passions of love. Come with me, my son.
Who could be happier than I? What heart could be more content?
For pity's sake, this is mad! Let me die!
You
shall not keep me from my love! Fredo!
Beatrice! Not dead!
No! Destiny!
My adored one!
quarter for my friend. So I made up the story to see if I could help him.
I never dreamed it was a portrait of you, or that you'd be so distressed that even the owner died. That's the whole truth, sir, from an honest man and a faithful servant.
That's an awfully long story he's telling.
So the man who got to the fence and letters in the post this morning was Pasquale?
Yes, sir, Pasquale!
Then why didn't you tell me when you knew how anxious I was to find out?
Because the man begged me not to tell a soul, sir.
You should have obeyed your master.
But I promised Pasquale to keep him from a thrashing.
You and Pasquale both deserve a thrashing.
In that case, I deserve both.
Have you not yet finished?
Oh, this fool's been telling
me. Oh, hold on, please don't give him away. Say it was me. Beat me if you have to, but please don't let any more trouble come to Pasquale.
Are you so loyal?
I love him as if he were my own flesh and blood. Let me go to the lady and take the blame. She'll likely scold me and do what she will to me, but I will protect my friend.
Well, he's certainly a loyal and upright sort.
Here I am, madam.
What took so long?
You must know, madam, that the gentleman has a servant named Pasquale. And he's not the brightest candle in the chandelier, if you follow me. It was he that made a mess of things, but because the poor man was afraid his master would dismiss him, leaving him unable to support his family of five little bambinos, cute as the dickens, all of them. Imagine those seven children! Think of them begging by the side of the road, there in the mud and grime, ribs poking out through the holes in their clothes. The littlest one, only this tall. Madam, he begged me to move! He begged me to tell the second. So I made up the story about the book and the master who was dead and drowned and all the rest of it just to help poor dim-witted Pasquale and his nine little bambinos.
This seemed to take an awfully long time.
But why take the blame for faults you never committed?
Madam, to save Pasquale! I beg you, madam, please don't let the man get into any more trouble.
Which man?
Pasquale!
Come, Signorina Van Fritchett. Our servants both deserve a thrashing, but considering our own great happiness, let's forget what's past.
But surely your servant.
It's me, I'm the Pasquale pay.
Well, I need to run along to Signor Castellani pen and pizzas. Will you go with me?
I have a meeting with my banker, but if you're in haste, I'll follow presently.
I am. You must go at once. I shall expect you at Signor Cancelone's.
Oh, I just realized I don't know where he lives.
I'll show you the way, sir.
Very well. But I better tidy myself before I go.
I'll be there directly, madam.
Uncle Brenda! What torment have I not endured for your love?
Mine have been no less, my darling, but all is mended now.
Sir, is that rascal Pasquale? He's nowhere to be found. Will you give me leave to wait upon Signorina Beatrice?
Yes, of course.
For invention and intrigue, I challenge any politician, except Dick Cheney.
I hope to ask you a favor.
A favor? After all you put us through?
Sir, please remember that any trouble is the cause of Pasquale.
Where is this Pasquale? Where is he? Invisible?
Oh, I'm sure he's around here somewhere right now. But about this favor,
what about it?
Well, you see, sir, I'm in love, too.
In love?
Yes, sir. With a girl. And she's here to see her Pasquale. And it would be very kind.
How do I come into it?
I won't
don't say, sir, that you come into it, but seeing as I am your servant, you may say a kind word to Signor Pantalone for me?
Well, we'll see if the girl wants her or not.
Oh, she wants me. No mistake. A kind word to Signor Pantalone. Please, sir, I beg you!
But how can you afford to keep a wife?
Well, I'll do what I can. Maybe I'll get some help from Pasquale.
You better look to someone with more sense.
Well, if I don't show sense this time, I never will.
Well,
you fight, but I'll be here for you.
You, a lord!
A dowry!
come in by your leave.
Is Florindo your young gentleman?
Indeed, my husband-to-be.
I'll be delighted to meet him.
Show him in.
My respects to you, young woman.
Pleased to see you, my red-headed cutie.
We will have a talk.
What about?
Are you willing?
Why not?
We will have a talk.
May I beg a favor of you, madam?
Oh, what is it?
I, too, am a poor young girl who would like to have a husband. Signorina Beatrice's servant wants to marry me. If you would say a kind word to his mistress and give her blessing, I should be the happiest girl in the world.
Dear Smeraldina, as soon as I can speak freely to Beatrice, I will certainly do so.
What is all this fuss about?
Nothing, sir. She has something to say to me.
May I not know?
How inquisitive men are, and they talk about us women.
Your most humble servant, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, are you the master of this house?
You may command me, sir.
No, sir. Allow me to have the honor of waiting upon you this evening. I am sent by the command of Signorina Beatrice, who is eventually known to you, and mine too.
Well, I am happy to know you, sir, and to see you here. I congratulate you most heartily on your good fortune.
Signorina Beatrice and I to be wed, if you will do us the honor, I hope you will enjoy the bride.
Well, if it is to be done, let it be done at once. Here, give her your hand.
Beatrice, I'm willing.
And I too, Florindo. Dear friend, I congratulate you.
And I you with all my heart.
Do you remember me, sir?
Indeed I do, sir. Nearly provoked me to a duel.
But I was well served for. Here's the opponent who disarmed me and could very well have ended my life.
And gave you your life, you might say?
Sister.
Only because I pleaded for you.
Very true.
Well, all has ended well and happily at that.
The best is yet to come, ladies and gentlemen.
What is yet to come?
With your good leave, sir. One word.
What word?
The word, sir, you promised.
What did I promise? I do not recollect.
Can I send your Pantalone for Smeraldina as before my wife?
Oh, yes, I'll do so at once.
I do want to put myself right in the world.
Signor Pantalone, I make bold as that favor.
You may come at me, sir.
My man's witness is to marry your maid. Have you any objections?
Another suitor? Who the devil could that be?
Well, for my part, I'm agreed. What do you say, girl?
Well, if I thought he would make a good husband.
For the short time I have known him, he has proved himself trustworthy with a good head on his shoulders.
Signor Florindo, I'm afraid you have anticipated me in a request I should have made. I was about to ask permission for Smeraldina to marry Signorina Beatrice's servant. You have asked for her for your servant, I can say no more.
In that case, I merely withdraw my request.
Oh, indeed, sir. I can never permit myself to have my own wishes preferred before yours. Pray continue in your proposal.
No.
Your most courteous Signorina Clarice. Signor Pantalone, I will not say a word on behalf of my servant. On the contrary, I refuse not to marry her.
Signor, we must be fair on both sides. If your man is not to marry her, no more shall the other.
Oh, here's a state of things. They pay each other compliments, and meanwhile, I am left without a husband.
Come, the poor girl wants to get married. Let us give her to one or the other.
Signorina, sir, allow me to settle the matter myself. Signor Florida, have you not asked that Smeraldina marry your servant?
I did you not hear me?
And you, Signorina Clarice, did you not intend that Smeraldina marry the servant of Signorina Beatrice?
That's what I intended.
In that case, give me your hand, Smeraldina.
By what right do you ask for a hand?
Well, Signor, I am the servant of Signor Florindo and of Signorina Beatrice.
What? Oh!
Signor Florindo, who asked you to ask Signor Pantalone and Smeraldina?
You did.
And you, Signorina Clarice, who was it you thought Smeraldina wanted to marry?
Yourself.
Ergo, thusly, Smeraldina is mine. Ipso, potato.
Beatrice, where's your servant?
Why here, Chapaldina?
Chapaldina is my servant.
But I thought your servant was Pasquale.
Pasquale, how's your servant?
Chapaldina!
You rascal!
You knave!
So you wait on two masks at once?
Yes, sir, I did, but that's the wonder. I took on the job without thinking, just to see what I could do. And if not for falling in love, well, no one would have been the wiser. So while I may have had my shortcomings, I worked hard for my wages, and earned a few extra wages at that. But you're fond of Beatrice. Silvio has his Clarice, and best of all, Smeraldina is mine.
Hey!
So all the people made you laugh and made you cry. Is the family
fiata più di spiette far me non può. Adollo fuoco coce ma si fuie e lassa sta. E non te copri a priesse non te struie solo a guardare.